Good afternoon and welcome to your weekly personal finance segment. We continue to see the Dow and S&P 500 trek higher, and given that equity prices do remain elevated, it's important for individual investors to diversify their portfolio. Today we'll be taking a closer look at ETFs and ETNs with Michael Keating of InnerHarbor Advisors. Mike, thanks for joining me today.
Thanks, Remy. Thanks for having me.
Well, as we continue to see equity prices trek higher and record highs for the Dow and S&P 500, it's important for individual investors out there to know what they're getting into and also be able to consider their risk as well as cost. So starting out with ETFs, can you give us a broad overview of what they are?
Sure. An ETF is simply an exchange-traded fund, So the fund is traded on an exchange like the New York Stock Exchange where we are today. And unlike other funds, like for example, a mutual fund or even a hedge fund, an investor can go onto an go through an exchange and buy and sell that fund, an ETF, every day, multiple times a day. Whereas with a mutual fund or a hedge fund, the investor has to go directly to the issuer, directly to the fund, and abide by their rules and their lockup periods, for example, in order to make investments or to sell their position.
And Mike, you've outlined some of the benefits, but in terms of taxes as well as cost and diversification, what are some other benefits for ETFs?
Those are some of the biggest benefits of ETFs. And at InnerHarbor, we're big proponents of ETFs, not in every situation, but overall, we're big users of ETFs. Think of an ETF as a basket of securities, usually stocks and bonds, a basket of securities that allows you diversification. So you can get you can buy, for example, the solar industry, or you can buy hundreds, if not thousands, of different companies, all in one security, all in one single stock-like security, in one transaction.
And Mike, that's important to consider, especially when you want to minimize your exposure. But in terms of exchange-traded notes, what's the difference?
So exchange-traded notes are traded on an exchange, as their name entails. Biggest difference between exchange-traded notes and exchange-traded funds is that there's a bank in the middle. So with a note, you're often buying something a lot more exotic or esoteric than a stock or a bond, as in an exchange-traded fund. With an exchange-traded note, you're buying things like commodities or derivatives. And these are things that aren't easily held by an individual. So the bank holds the products and then passes investment returns through, whether they are profits or losses. It's important to keep in mind that with an exchange-traded note, unlike a fund, you don't own the underlying securities, and therefore you own an unsecured note with the bank. And so you have something called counterparty risk. If the bank were to fail, you become an unsecured creditor of that bank.
Well, you brought up some very important points there. So if you're a beginner when it comes to ETFs or ETNs, what would you say is a good place to start, and what are some of the basic ABCs?
There are a number of places to start. First of all, if you don't have enough time or you don't have interest in these types of things, see a financial advisor. Speak to somebody who knows what they're doing. But if you do have some time, there's a lot of resources online. I mean, a shameless plug here for iShares. They do a great job with their online education, both for advisors and for the individual investors. It's important also to keep in mind that while an exchange-traded fund or an exchange-traded note is a basket, it's important to know what is in that basket, okay? And take a look at what's in that basket. At InnerHarbor Advisors, we use very straightforward exchange-traded funds, but there are a number of different exotic funds out there where you can say go double long a market or profit if the market goes down. These are things that are really for sophisticated professional investors, and you should really, again, see that basket, take a look at what's inside of it before you buy it.
Well, Mike, I think that's sage advice regarding investing in terms of going to your financial advisor. But do you think there are any drawbacks to any of these products?
Well, there's always drawbacks, right? So you are taking on market risk, and with exchange-traded notes, you're adding the counterparty risk. So in times like this, you mentioned the markets are going up. Know what you're buying. Know that the money that you're putting into that may go down in value, and know your time horizon for it. So even though with ETFs they're a lot more transparent, there's a lot of tax advantages versus mutual funds, know what you're buying and know that they could go down in value.
Okay, those are some very important tips to keep in mind. So thank you so much today for giving us an overview of ETFs and ETNs, and next week we'll take a closer look at those products. Thank you very much.
Great, thanks, Jeremy.